Hello students, so today we are going to start with a new topic, that is wave theory of light. Now before we start with the discussion, let us take one step back and understand what is the meaning of word light. What is meaning of word light? Light is basically the form of energy and it propagates in the medium in the form of electromagnetic waves. Those electromagnetic waves are basically formed because of vibrations of electric field, and those vibrating electric field generates magnetic field in the perpendicular direction. This we have seen in last year's electromagnetic waves topic. We have also seen that electromagnetic waves basically range in different wavelengths. Very small electromagnetic waves are called as gamma rays. Gamma se bada x-ray. X-ray peksha mota asto ultraviolet, vibgyor, infrared, microwave and radio wave. So we have got different range and the whole thing is called as electromagnetic spectrum, right? So we have basic idea about light, but earlier in 16th or 17th century, people really didn't knew what is meaning of light or how light basically propagates. Yes, we know what is light, right? The light coming from the different sources, light coming from sun, we know that there is light, but what exactly is the way of propagation of light was not clear in those times. Right now we have the understanding that light is an electromagnetic wave. Even in the recent times we have also proved that light can also travel in form of particles, but earlier it was not clear. So different theories of light came and many of them were incorrect and those theories were discarded. But in order to understand the perfect, in order to understand the exact explanation, in order to understand the exact concept behind light, we must also study those theories which were earlier discovered or earlier proposed. So this goes back in 17th century, where Dutch scientist Christian Huygens suggested a theory which was called as wave theory of light, and he suggested that light basically travels in form of waves. And in the same time, there was one more scientist named Isaac Newton who suggested that light is not a wave, but light is a particle. Both the theories were fundamentally different. One theory suggested that light is a wave, the other one suggested that light is a particle. For many years, decades, centuries, both the theories were working, but Newton's theory was accepted. But later on, in the end of 17th or 18th century, one experiment which was conducted by Thomas Young proved that the light ka nature is wave nature and not the particle. Later on in 20th century, that is 1900 1901 or 1902, in the starting of 20th century, Max Planck proved that the light can also behave as particles or energy packets called as photons. So all these theories we need to understand, or we need to learn to understand the propagation of light through medium. So first, in this particular topic, we are going to focus only on one theory, that is Huygens' wave theory of light. Obviously, to understand Huygens' theory, we must also know other theories, what other theories proposed. But major focus of this topic will only be on the single theory, that is Huygens' wave theory of light. So let us start with the discussion. Okay, so this is timeline basically. And in the timeline, you can see that between 1600 and 1700, two scientists, Christian Huygens and Isaac Newton, basically proposed two different theories about light. One was the wave theory, which we are going to discuss. The wave theory is basically Huygens' theory, okay? The Huygens' wave theory of light, we are going to discuss in this topic. And then Isaac Newton's particle theory, which was called as corpuscular theory, which we will discuss in detail as well. In the 17th century, these two theories were there. But in 1873, in this range, electromagnetic theory was proposed by James Maxwell, which clearly shows that light travels not only in form of normal waves, they travel in form of electromagnetic waves. The word electromagnetic means light is basically vibrations of fields and not the particles. And as it is not the vibration of particles, medium is not necessary. Right from sun to Earth, there is complete vacuum, but still light can travel. The reason is it is not a normal wave. It is electromagnetic wave. This happened in the late 1800, and then in 1902 or 1901, over a year, Max Planck proposed the theory of that is called as quantum theory of light, in which light is energy packet. Light is a shower of energy packets. So these were different theories, and in those theories, today we are only going to discuss on this theory, that is Huygens wave theory of light. So let us move to the theory of light, Huygens wave theory of light. Okay, so let's go to the next slide. So before we start with the Huygens wave theory of light, we must also understand Huygens wave theory ke saath mein jo theory tha, that was Newton's theory. What was the problem with those theories? Actually, dono ke theory mein problems hai, but even though the name of the lesson is wave theory of light, we must also understand ki uske saath jo theory, Newton ka theory tha, what was that theory called and what were the points of those theory. Even though major topic wave theory pe hi focus karenge, lekin introduction part mein thode basic information about these theories also given. So let us see what is Newton's corpuscular theory of light. The name of the theory was Newton's corpuscular theory. Corpuscle is particle, so it is Newton's particle theory. According to this theory, you will see that light travels in form of tiny particles called as corpuscles. Newton also gave the properties to these particles. These corpuscles are perfectly elastic, rigid and weightless. So those corpuscles, if they are incident on some certain object, those collisions will be perfectly elastic. We have studied this perfectly elastic concept in the topic Newton's laws of motion, right? If you remember, what is perfectly elastic collision? The collision in which there is no loss of kinetic energy, right? So these corpuscles are perfectly elastic, they are rigid and they are weightless. The third point is the corpuscle travel in straight line with a very high speed. In those times, the speed of light was not exactly known. So in those times, we used to assume, or we knew that light travels at a very large speed, but exact speed was not known. It was known that light travels with a very large speed, but that speed changes with the medium. Matlab, water mein speed will be different, air mein speed will be different, in the glass speed will be different. So even Newton's theory suggested that yes, corpuscles travel in a straight line with a very, very large speed, but which is different for different media. The problem with this, with the third point was, which is not mentioned in the third point, what was the problem? Newton said that light travels with different speed in different media. Fine, even we know that now. But according to Newton, light travels faster in a denser medium, and the speed is slower, it travels slowly in a rarer medium, which is not the correct case. Right now we know that light travels fast in rarer and slow in denser. So that was the problem with the theory. It is not mentioned over here. We will study it in drawbacks of this theory. Okay, so first point is light is a particle called corpuscle. Second point is light ke corpuscles are perfectly elastic, rigid and weightless. These corpuscles travel in a straight line with a very high speed, with different, which is different for different media. Media means it is a plural of medium. Okay. Next point is, when do we get the sensation of light? We get sensation of light when these corpuscles fall on the retina. Remember, you cannot see those corpuscles. Matlab aise nahi hai ki light on kiya to corpuscles you can see. Like if you start the shower, you see the water drops falling, right? If the water drop is not falling on your eye, still you can see that it is traveling. But it is not in the case of light. If you switch on the bulb, the shower of corpuscles will fall on you, but you cannot see those corpuscles which are falling aside. You can only see those corpuscles which are entering in your eye. So that is the fourth point. We can sense light only when the corpuscles fall on the retina. You can see the figure. Corpuscles, when they will fall on the retina, you will get the sensation of light. Now in this figure, you can clearly see that corpuscles ke size alag alag hai. Smaller corpuscle, big one, medium size, all different types of corpuscle. Uske meaning kya hai, dekho? The meaning is, fifth point, different colors of light are due to different size of corpuscles. This was Newton's statement, okay? different size, different colors. Means if you take red color corpuscle will be a large corpuscle. Example I'm taking. Blue color will be small, green color will be average, and so on. Different colors, different size. Now all these theory was in 17th century, 1650, 1680 ka this theory is. So at that time, it was not really clear ki light kaise travel karta hai. So these things were accepted in those times. Now we know those things are not correct. Okay, so whether Newton's corpuscular theory is correct, quickly we will revise it. Newton's corpuscular theory mein 5 points kya hai? First point is Newton's corpuscular theory says that light travels in form of tiny particles called corpuscles. Second, these corpuscles are perfectly elastic, rigid, weightless. Third point, they travel in the straight line with very large speed, which is different for different media. Fourth point, we can only get the sensation, we can only see the light when light falls on the retina. And fifth point is different colors are because of different size of these corpuscles. Clear? So this was Newton's corpuscular theory, which was proposed along with the wave theory. Wave theory or corpuscular theory mein there was constant debate. So is theory mein, that is corpuscular theory mein, what were the problems? Okay, drawbacks. Drawbacks with the corpuscular theory were, first, Newton's corpuscular theory could not explain these points. Partial reflection and refraction. See, what is meaning of partial reflection and refraction? We know that when light is incident, if the surface is refracting, the light refracts. Correct? But actually what happens is, if you take a glass slab, and on the glass slab if the light is incident, if 100 rays are incident, not all the rays will refract. Suppose 70 refract ho gaye, toh 30 will reflect. 30 rays will reflect. For example, 30 rays will reflect and they will follow I equal to R. I equals to R. They will follow this rule. So when light is incident on certain medium, some of the light is reflected and some of the light is refracted. This concept is called as partial reflection and refraction. He could not explain this. Newton could explain reflection only. He could explain refraction only. Kaise explain kiya? It is not mentioned in this slide, but Newton explained reflection in this way. What he said was, when the corpuscles are falling, if they are falling on the water surface attracts those corpuscles. So because of the attraction, those corpuscles ka direction changes, and this is how refraction takes place. Reflection ko usne kaise explain kiya? If you take a mirror, and if corpuscles are falling on that mirror, the mirror ka surface surface repels those corpuscles. Repels means push. So those corpuscles will basically bounce. So that is how he explained the reflection of light. But he could not explain reflection and refraction, because a same material cannot absorb, cannot attract and repel simultaneously. So he could not explain the first point. That is, he could not explain this point, partial reflection and refraction. Second, he could not explain these properties. Now, right now, at this stage, you don't know what these properties mean, because you will study this later on. The properties are interference, diffraction, and polarization, which we will cover. This topics will be covered later on. Interference, diffraction, and polarization are basically wave ke properties. So obviously, particle nature can never prove it. So interference, diffraction, and polarization, he could not explain. Third point he could not explain was, already I have told you in the previous slide, that according to Newton, speed of light in denser is greater than rarer. But right now, experimentally, we have proved, we know that rarer mein speed is greater, denser mein speed is small. So that was the problem with the theory. Another point was the mass of source. If I say a bulb is emitting different particles, eventually 1 year, 2 year, 10 year, 20 years ke baad, the bulb ka mass should decrease. But there was no such decrease or reduction in mass observed. Even though experiments were done, the mass of the source remains same, no mass decrease. So that was the drawback, right? So Newton's corpuscular theory ke ye drawbacks hai. Which things he could not explain were, he could not explain partial reflection and refraction, first point. He could not explain interference, diffraction, and polarization was the second point. Third point is, he could not explain speed in denser. According to Newton's theory, speed in denser is greater, which is wrong. So this point, third point, was also wrong. And fourth, the source ka mass should decrease, which was wrong. So these were the problems with the Newton's corpuscular theory. So once Newton's theory, we have just taken an overview of this theory. The main part of this topic is focused on the Huygens wave theory. So we will go back, we will now jump on to the main part of this lesson, that is Huygens wave theory of light. Very important, very interesting theory, very easy to understand, very simple theory it is. Okay, so Christian Huygens' wave theory of light. Let us have a look at the first point. According to Huygens, light travels in form of longitudinal waves, which travels with a uniform velocity in homogeneous medium. It was later proved to be transverse. So first point is very simple. Huygens' ka first statement was light travels in form of waves. Which waves? Huygens said that light travels in form of waves which are longitudinal. See, this word is important. According to Huygens, light is a longitudinal wave which travels with a uniform speed, constant speed se travel karti hai in homogeneous medium. Homogeneous matlab single phase wala medium. The medium having a single phase matlab water to pura water, glass to pura glass, no change in the mediums abruptly or no gradual change as well. Homogeneous medium is the medium which has constant phase, no change in phase. Whether the first point is clear? आगे देखो लिखा है यहाँ पे, later it was proved to be transverse. So ये Huygens का theory था कि Huygens ने बताया light is a longitudinal wave, but that is not correct. Correct is light is a transverse wave, और साधा wave नहीं है, light is a electromagnetic wave, right? So second point, different colors of light are due to different size of waves or different wavelengths. Different size, different colors are because of different lambda, correct? For example, red color का wavelength is large, बड़ा wave, 6400 angstrom minute. Blue color or violet color is a smaller wave, it is only 4000 angstrom minute. So even that thing we know right now. So even Huygens suggested that different colors are because of different wavelengths. That was true. Third point, we get the sensation of light when these waves enter the eye. Again, the same point was also repeated in Newton's theory that we can only get the sensation of light when the corpuscle fall on retina. Yahan pe wave should enter the eye. If the wave is traveling, light wave is traveling, you cannot see it. You can only feel the wave when it enters. You can only sense the wave when the wave enters the eye. And the last point was really important point in this theory. See, what was the last point? Ye last point jo tha, it was clearly made up just in order to support the theory. See, I'll just erase that point first. Ye jo theory hai, Huygens wave theory, iske first three points are clear, okay? उसने बताया लाइट इज़ अ लॉन्जिट्यूडनल वेव, फाइन. डिफरेंट वेवलेंथ, डिफरेंट कलर्स, फाइन. लाइट का सेंसेशन वी गेट व्हेन इट एंटर्स द आई. बट ये जो थियरी Huygens का थियरी था, व्हेन ही प्रपोज दिस थियरी, डिफरेंट साइंटिस्ट्स क्वेश्चन्ड दैट अगर लाइट वेव है, इफ लाइट इज अ वेव, देन वेव रिक्वायर्स पार्टिकल, एंड इफ वेव रिक्वायर पार्टिकल, देन हाउ कम लाइट फ्रॉम सन इज रीचिंग अर्थ इवन दो देर इज नो मीडियम. How light can reach from sun to earth? Beech mein toh vacuum hai. Sun and earth, if you observe this thing, see, sun and earth ke beech mein there is complete vacuum, there is nothing between, vacuum hai pura. So how sun ke waves can reach earth? Because light ke liye, if you say, if Huygens says light is a wave, then how you can prove that sun se earth mein wave can travel, because no medium is there. So just to explain light vacuum mein se bhi travel kar sakta hai. See, he could not say that light travels through vacuum directly, because if light travels through vacuum, then how it could be a wave? Because wave tabhi ka understanding aisa tha ki wave can only travel if there is a medium, because wave matlab particle ka vibration, successive vibration, right? So agar vacuum mein wave travel karta hai, then there is no particle, how light can travel through vacuum? So he suggested something else. Huygens made up the fourth point. See, what was that point? A material medium is necessary for propagation of longitudinal waves, correct? So to explain the propagation of wave through vacuum, Huygens suggested that the existence of an hypothetical medium, imaginary medium called luminiferous ether, called luminiferous ether, which was supposed to be present throughout. What Huygens said, ki no, sun to earth light vacuum nahi hai, sun to earth there is imaginary medium. Usko usne naam de diya luminiferous ether. That medium is present everywhere, he suggested, ki nahi, universe mein vacuum nahi hai, universe mein there is a constant medium present everywhere. Therefore, light can travel through that medium. What was the name of that hypothetical imaginary medium? The name of that medium was luminiferous ether. And Once he suggested that there was ether, other scientists started finding that ether. So just to make that search difficult, ki ether kaise milna nahi chahiye unko, just to make that search difficult, he also suggested that ether ke properties bahut hi extreme properties hai, jaise ki zero density hai, ether ko density nahi hai, ether ke liye perfect transparency hai. So he made things difficult for the scientist, so other scientists could not detect that ether. Right? So this was just a hypothetical made up point in order to support the theory. So these were the points in Huygens wave theory. Okay, just we will quickly revise those points before we move to the next slide. Huygens wave theory of light, very important point. Remember students, first point is Huygens wave theory of light says that light is a longitudinal wave, not a transverse, longitudinal, and it travels with high speed in with a uniform speed in a homogeneous medium. Later it was proved to be transverse, but that was not Huygens' Huygens' discovery. Huygens said that light is a longitudinal. Second, why different colors exist in light? Because waves are of different size, chota wave, bada wave. We know that red wave is a large wave, violet is small. So different colors, different wavelength. Third point, we get sensation when light enters the eye. What is the fourth point? A material medium is necessary for propagation of longitudinal wave. So to explain propagation of light through vacuum mein se light travel kaise karta hai? This was the question asked by other scientists. So what he said was, no, there is no vacuum. Everywhere in the space, hypothetical medium is present. He named it as luminiferous ether. And in that, ether wave can travel. That was his suggestion, right? So these were the points in Huygens wave theory of light. And now we will move to the next point. What were the merits, positives, and what were the demerits, negatives? Okay, so moving to the next point now. Merits and demerits, that is positives and negatives of this theory. So according to Huygens, we know that what was the Huygens wave theory of light. What were the positives of this theory? Huygens could explain reflection of light. He could explain refraction of light. He could explain interference of light, as well as he could explain diffraction of light. Now already I have told you that all these properties, reflection, refraction, interference, diffraction, are the properties of waves. And Huygens' theory is wave theory. So obviously he could explain all this phenomena. Now interference diffraction, ye jo discovery hua, ya interference diffraction ka experimental proof hua ki light interfere karta hai, light diffract karta hai. Those were done in late 18th century or late 17th century, where Huygens and Newton both were not present, right? But even though they were not present in those times, in 1800, 1700, but the theory that was proposed by Huygens supported that phenomena. So interference diffraction was not Huygens' time ka ya Newton's time ka concept. So interference diffraction was experimentally proved by Thomas Young. We will study that experiment called as Young's experiment, Young's double slit experiment. Okay, for right now, we just need to understand ki what things he could explain correctly, positives kya hai theory ke. He could explain reflection, refraction, interference, diffraction, and the most important point, ki according to Huygens, speed in rarer was greater than denser. Newton ke according, speed in denser is greater than rarer. So it was clearly a wrong point for Newton. So Huygens correctly suggested ki rarer mein speed zyada hona chahiye. In those time, experimental apparatus were not so advanced that speed of light could be measured easily. But Foucault proved later on that speed in rarer is greater than denser. So even that is a positive point of Huygens' theory. There were negatives, that is demerits of this theory. First, he could not explain rectilinear propagation. Rectilinear means straight line propagation. Okay, with a very high speed, we know that light travels and it travels in a straight line. Sound jaise nahi, if I have a speaker over here, sound wave will go everywhere in this room. But if I have a torch in this room, it will only go straight. Torch ka light will only go straight. That is called as rectilinear propagation. So demerits mein, he could not explain rectilinear propagation. Second, he could not explain polarization of light. Now this polarization concept is also a property of wave. Why Huygens could not explain it? Remember, polarization ye jo property hai, this property polarization, this property is basically property of a transverse wave. Transverse wave ka property hai wo. And transverse wave ka agar property polarization hai, then how Huygens could explain it? Because Huygens according, light is not a transverse, it is a longitudinal wave. So obviously he could not explain this property. Later on, it was proved ki light is a transverse wave. So even polarization light show karta hai. We will discuss it in this topic itself later on. Okay, the next property he could not explain was these properties later on. Huygens could not explain photoelectric effect, Compton effect, Raman effect. All these effects are basically based on quantum theory of light, which is Max Planck's quantum theory. Using that Max Planck's quantum theory, we can explain these effects. So obviously light ka wave theory cannot explain. Right now our present understanding about light is ki light ko wave nature bhi hai, light ko particle nature bhi hai. Light has got both the nature. We call it as a dual nature of light. This is our present understanding. Depending on which property we are explaining, we use that particular theory. For example, if I am explaining reflection of light, I won't jump into quantum theory. I will just use wave theory. Reflection ke liye, refraction ke liye, I will use the theory which is wave theory. But when we go into particle theory, that is these effects, photoelectric, Raman, Compton, for these effects we cannot use wave theory of light. We need to use the quantum theory of light, that is quantum particle or particle theory of light, right? So even Huygens could not explain these properties. Okay, in fact these properties were not invented or these effects were not even studied in those times. Later on when these effects were studied, Huygens' theory could not support that these particular effects. Next, according to Huygens, light is which wave? Light is a longitudinal wave, which is wrong. Light is a transverse, so that will come under demerit. And last point is presence of ether. I already told you that was a made up point. Just to help the theory, usne banaya wo point which was completely wrong. Okay, no presence of ether were detected after different attempts to search the ether. So presence of ether was also wrong. So these were the points, merits and demerits mein. Phir se, once again we will revise those points very quickly. What were the merits? Merits of this theory were, he could explain reflection, refraction, interference, diffraction, and according to theory, speed in rarer is greater than speed in denser. Demerits mein kya hai? Rectilinear propagation, straight line propagation he could not explain, polarization he could not explain because of transverse nature, uska suggestion tha light is a longitudinal. Third point he could not explain was photoelectric, Raman, Compton effects. What are these Raman effect, Compton effect, photoelectric effect? We will discuss it in modern physics section, okay? So don't worry about it. Light is a longitudinal wave was also the wrong assumption, and presence of ether he could not, was wrong. Scientists tried, different attempts were made, but the ether was not detected. Ether was not found. So these were the merits and demerits. So now, till now we have covered two important points, two important basic introduction of two theories, wave theory ka introduction and corpuscular theory ka. Okay, so once these two theories are completed, we will move to the next point now, that is the wave theory ka next part is wavefront. Okay, before we start with the wavefront section, just I want to make it clear, in this lesson everything after this point is only focused on wave theory. Okay, Newton's corpuscular theory was only those two slides, do hi points hai, introduction ki what was Newton's corpuscular theory and what were the problems. After that we have switched to the next part, that is wave theory, and in wave theory we will discuss in detail everything about the wave theory. Okay, so next point now is wavefront. Okay, wave theory, to understand wave theory there are some points that you must know, there are some terms you must know. So those terms we are going to discuss now. First term jo hai, that is a wavefront. What is meaning of wavefront? See, you can see the definition. Wavefront is a locus of all points of medium to which the wave reaches simultaneously, so that all the points are in the same state of or same phase. All the points are in the same phase. The word important hai. Same phase is important. For example, I have shown a two-dimensional water waves pond mein, two-dimensional water waves. When you throw a pebble or a stone in a pond, a still water lake, what will happen is a ripples or waves will start propagating. Suppose if I stop time somewhere, how to stop this slide, I will just right click over here. So because of that, what happens is you can see that the waves stop ho gaye, right? If I draw a circle, jahan pe pure crest hai na, right? Crest is present. That circle is called as a wavefront, where the wave reaches simultaneously from each point. Okay? So, again I'll explain this. It is locus of all points of medium to which wave reaches simultaneously. Means, if this is the source, from this source the wave will start traveling in this direction, wave will start traveling in this direction, everywhere wave is traveling. So once the wave starts traveling at t equal to 0, waves originate hue, t equal to 0 se wave start hue. Let us say wave is traveling with 5 meter per second, 5 meter yahan pe t equal to 0 pe start hue. After t equal to 1 second kitna distance travel karega ye wave? 5 meter, yahan pe 5 meter, yahan pe 5 meter and yahan pe 5 meter. So basically 5 meter ka ek circle banega jahan pe wave would reach simultaneously, all the waves will reach simultaneously. Aur wo jo circle hai, that circle is called as a wavefront. So what is a wavefront? It is the locus of points where wave from the source reaches simultaneously. And all points are in the same phase. What is meaning of same phase? Matlab yahan se 5 meter ke baad crest hai, to yahan pe bhi 5 meter ke baad crest hai, yahan pe bhi crest hai and yahan pe bhi crest hai. Means all the points are on the crest. They will go in trough, crest, trough, crest. So they will basically expand in same phase. They will vibrate with the same phase. Now this is 2D. But when we talk about 3D, if I take a point source or bulb over here, and bulb, when I will switch it on, the wave will travel up, wave will travel down, right, left, towards you, away from you. Basically, it will travel in all directions. And after some time, if I stop it, just for explanation purpose, if I stop the time, you will see that there is a sphere jahan tak light gayi hai. Is mein se jo nikli hai light wave, all those waves will reach a sphere. That sphere ka surface is called as a wavefront. Correct? So whether wavefront is clear, what is meaning of wavefront? Wavefront is the locus of point where wave from the source reaches simultaneously. Ab wavefront ka surface kaise ho sakta hai? It could be a sphere. Abhi dikhaya maine example. It could be a sphere. 2D wave mein it is a circle, but 3D wave mein it will be a sphere. It is a spherical surface. There are more surfaces possible. If you think, thoda detail mein think karenge, to you will get more understanding of this wave, of this wavefront. Okay, right now the wavefront that we have discussed is a spherical shape wavefront. But just imagine, instead of a point source, if I take a linear source like a tube light, what will happen? Tube light may say upper end and lower end is closed, so light won't go up and down. Only what will happen, through this linear source, light will start traveling outward, cylindrical shape banega, right? Cylindrical wavefront. So that is example of cylindrical wavefront. So wavefront ke types dekho, what are different types? There are three standard types of wavefronts. Spherical wavefront is a sphere. How to form it? We will discuss it. But spherical wavefront ke liye we need a point source. Point source se jaise waves will come out, it will form a spherical wavefront. Second type of wavefront is a plane wavefront. Now what is a plane wavefront? See, plane wavefront kya hota hai? If I take a point source and as the time will start, it will become a spherical wavefront. And agar ye spherical wavefront grow hota hai size mein, it will just grow in size. After large amount of time, the sphere will become so large that usme se if I take a small cut, small part of it, it will become a plane. Jaise ki earth is a sphere, correct? Earth is a sphere, but the room in which I am sitting is a plane. Why it is a plane? Even we are sitting on a spherical shaped planet, why the room is plane? Because the room ka area, this particular section ka area is very very small as compared to the whole area, correct? So spherical wavefront eventually bada hone ke baad, it can be treated as a plane wavefront, because all the sphere will become so large that uska small section can be treated as a plane. And cylindrical wavefront already I have explained. See, I'll explain it with slides, with these figures. Okay, spherical wavefront ke liye, if you need a point source, if you have a point source, the light will come in all direction. This is shown in 2D, but actually light is also coming towards you, right, towards you. It is also going back, so it will form a sphere in this way. So this white particular thing shown over here, white thing, is a wavefront. What is those yellow things or green? Wo green arrows jo hai, wo waves hai. Aur white jo hai, wo wavefront hai. Wavefront is not something physical thing, ki usko touch nahi kar sakte. It is just imaginary concept, wavefront. So how a spherical wavefront is made? Spherical wavefront is produced by taking a point source. Second is a plane wavefront. How to make a plane wavefront? Already I have explained. Plane wavefront ke liye, take a point source and uska ek bada sphere bana. Means you can do it another way. Take a point source and place it at infinity. If the point source is at infinity, the waves coming through it will almost be a plane wavefront. So this red color thing is a plane wavefront. Okay. See, this particular thing is a plane wave front, and where is the source? Source is at infinity. यहाँ पे source है infinity. Okay, this is a plane wave front. Plane wave front you can also make it in some other way. There is one more way of making a plane wave front. That is place a point source at the focus of a convex lens. ये convex lens है, right? इसके focus पे if I place a point source, the rays will diverge. It will come out spherical wave front. ये देखो, I will show you. ये जो point source है ना, this point source, ये point source से how the wave front is coming out? A spherical wave front is coming out, right? But once that spherical wave front is incident on a convex lens, उसके बाद all those rays become parallel to each other and the wave front is a plane wave front now. ये plane wave front propagate होगा अभी. So plane wave front can be made by two ways. Light source should be at infinity, and second, light source should be placed on the focus of a convex lens. So this is the second point. Moving to the next point, third wavefront is a cylindrical wavefront. First okay, spherical, second have plane, third is a cylindrical. How to make a cylindrical wavefront? Already I have explained. Take a tube light, linear source bolte hai usko. Linear source se jo wave niklenge, the wavefront will be a cylindrical wavefront. This figure clearly shows cylindrical wavefront kaise. Okay, tube light example dekho. Tube light emits cylindrical wavefront, light emerging from a slit. What is meaning of a slit? Take a cardboard. कार्डबोर्ड को एक वर्टिकल लाइन कट करो, दैट वर्टिकल लाइन इज कॉल्ड एज अ स्लिट. सो लाइट कमिंग फ्रॉम दिस, ये स्लिट से लाइट कैसे निकलेंगे? सिलेंड्रिकल निकलेंगे बाहर, सिलेंड्रिकल शेप, राइट? सो दैट इज कॉल्ड एज अ सिलेंड्रिकल वेव फ्रंट. ओके, सो वेदर थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ वेव फ्रंट्स आर क्लियर. थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ वेव फ्रंट, स्पेरिकल वेव फ्रंट, प्लेन वेव फ्रंट एंड सिलेंड्रिकल वेव फ्रंट. स्पेरिकल वेव फ्रंट, सिलेंड्रिकल वेव फ्रंट एंड प्लेन वेव फ्रंट से पहले वेव फ्रंट का मीनिंग यू मस्ट अंडरस्टैंड. वॉट इज अ वेव फ्रंट? वेव फ्रंट इज अ लोकस ऑफ पॉइंट्स वेयर द वेव रीचेस साइमल्टेनियसली. वेन द वेव रीचेस साइमल्टेनियसली सो दैट ऑल दोज पॉइंट्स आर इन द सेम फेज. अगेन आई एम रिपीटिंग, वेव फ्रंट इज नॉट ऑब्जेक्ट विच यू कैन टच फिजिकली. वेव फ्रंट इज जस्ट इमेजिनरी कंसेप्ट. इट इज अ ग्रुप ऑफ पॉइंट जहाँ पर वेव साइमल्टेनियसली रीच होती है, राइट? थ्री टाइप्स के वेव फ्रंट्स वी हैव डिस्कस्ड. We will move to the next point. So first term is clear, what is meaning of wavefront. Second term is wave normal. What is wave normal? Wave normal is basically perpendicular drawn to the wavefront. Now wavefront agar plane hai, I can draw two perpendicular, bahar ek, andar ek. Which wavefront I should take? Wavefront drawn to the surface of the wavefront, wavefront drawn to the surface of the wavefront at any point on the wavefront in the direction of propagation of light. This is important. In the direction of propagation of light. So, agar light us direction mein ja rahi hai, toh you should draw perpendicular in those directions. Example dekho. Okay? Example dekho yahan pe. What is a wave normal present over here? Where is the wave normal present in this figure? In this figure, you can see these are the wave normals. Correct? Because light is direction mein ja rahi hai. These are wave normals. All these things are wave normals. So wave normal is basically the ray of light. Simple language mein, what is wave normal? Wave normal is a ray of light. Ray of light is always perpendicular to the wavefront and it is going in the direction of light. So wave normal basically gives the direction of light. Simple language mein, you can call it in this way. Okay, so even this point is clear. What is wavefront and what is wave normal? So wave theory mein, we have started with the meaning, the basic explanation, what was the theory that he said that light is a wave, longitudinal wave. Then he said that different colors are because of different wavelengths and all those points, ether wala point. After that, we have seen uske merits kya hai, demerits kya hai. And then we have started with new terms. Ye theory explain karne ke liye, we need some terms. So first term was wave front, second term was wave normal. Wave front is the locus of all points where wave reaches simultaneously. And wave normal is the perpendicular drawn to the wavefront in the direction of light, correct? So, just to understand this question, this particular concept of wavefront more clearly, I will give you one more example. Just imagine that if there is a source of light, for example, a bulb, and bulb mein se wave is coming out. If you are sitting on the top of the wave, correct? Ek wave ke top pe, if you are sitting, just imaginary concept. And similarly, everyone is sitting on the top of those particular waves. So basically, you will be sitting on the wavefront ka surface. And as the time will go, the radius of that particular wavefront will grow in size. So your position, you will be away from the source. You will go away from the source. Correct? So wavefront is nothing but imaginary surface. You cannot sit practically on that surface. It was just for explanation purpose. So let's move to the next point, Huygens principle. Okay. So let's move to the next point, that is Huygens principle. Huygens wave theory is different, and Huygens wave theory ke under ye section hai Huygens principle. See, first point, every point on a wavefront behaves as if it is a secondary source of light sending secondary waves in all possible direction. What is meaning of this? It means if this is a source of light, we will call it as a bulb, as a primary source. From this source, light rays are coming in every direction. So it will form a sphere. Yes, sphere ko kya bolte hai? We call it as a wavefront. So wavefront pe imaginary points jitne hai, infinite points, right? Every point will act as ki wo khud source hai. Itself it is a source. So agar wo khud source hai, point source hai, so unme se light niklenge all direction mein. So every point on the wavefront behaves as if it is a secondary source of light sending secondary waves in all possible direction. Correct? So if there is a point source from which the light is coming out, every point will act as secondary source and emit secondary waves in all possible direction. Second point is, these secondary wavelets, matlab secondary wavelets ka meaning kya hai? Ye primary source hai. Primary source se light nikli, wavefront bana. Wavefront ke every point are acting as wo khud secondary source hai. They are emitting their small wavelets. Wavelets matlab secondary wavefront ke wave, secondary sources ke wavefronts are called as wavelets. These secondary wavelets are more effective in forward direction. Obvious hai ye, means forward direction mein kyun effective hai? Because yahan se agar torch, if I point torch in this way, light will travel. Correct? Wavefront will travel. Ye jo wavefront, every point will act as secondary source. So they will emit secondary waves in all direction. So peeche bhi emit kar sakte hai na, all direction matlab. But peeche effective nahi zyada, more effective in forward direction. That is why torch yahan pe mara to peeche light nahi jayegi. Light will only go in one direction because they are more effective in forward direction. Now this is just explanation of the theory. Okay. Third point is, the resultant wavefront at any position is given by tangent to all these secondary wavelets at that instant. You will not understand this point only by reading it. You need to see the next slide for this. I will just move to the next slide. See how spherical wavefront actually propagates. Dekho, spherical wavefront kaise propagate karta. Let us say this is point source. If there is a point source, how the wavefront is? Wavefront is spherical wavefront. I have just shown the smaller section of that wavefront. Red color ka kya hai? Red color ka hai wavefront. And what are those orange lines? Those are wave normals or rays of light. Correct? Whether it is clear? Now, according to Huygens theory, what Huygens theory says that every point on this wavefront will act as what? Every point on this wavefront will act it as itself was source of light. Matlab ye jaise source hai na, ye source hai jaise. Waise every point will act ki wo khud ek source hai. And therefore it will start emitting the waves in all direction. All direction they will start emitting rays. Correct? So I will show it. See? These white dots, I am not considering all points because practically sub points nahi dikha sakte yahan pe. I have only considered 5 points. Those 5 points are acting as if they are source themselves, and they will start emitting waves in all directions. Dekho, jaise first has started emitting waves in all directions. Aage bhi, peeche bhi, everywhere. So first point ka ye meaning hai ki every point on the wavefront acts as secondary source. They emit secondary waves in all possible directions. Correct? So every point is acting as secondary source and emitting waves in all possible direction. Second point kya tha? Second point was that these wavefronts are more effective in forward direction. So forward direction mein zyada effective hai, backward direction mein less effective hai. And third point was what? Third point was ki ye jo red wavefront hai na, ye original wavefront hai. But after propagation, wo wavefront aage kaise badhega? So if I draw common tangent agar draw kiya, in sub spheres ko common tangent do draw kar sakta hu main. One I can draw on the other side and one on the rear side. So according to the third rule, the tangent to all these wavelets will give you the resultant position of the new wavefront. Ye old wavefront hai ye wala old wavefront hai, ye wala new wavefront hai. New wavefront aage kaise badha? Just by drawing the tangent. Backward direction mein why I have drawn a dotted tangent? Because less effective hai backward, forward zyada effective hai. So again, new wavefront pe every point will act as secondary wavefront, they will emit secondary waves, fir se tangent draw karo, fir se every point, and in this way tangent will just, the wave will propagate in forward direction. So whether it is clear how spherical wavefront propagates in this way, okay? Just I will remove this part. See, again I'll explain. There was a point source, it emits light in all direction. I have considered a smaller section called a spherical wavefront. Spherical wavefront pe all the points on that wavefront is acting as secondary source of light, emitting secondary waves in all possible direction. Unme se forward direction mein hi zyada effective hai, so tangent wahan pe draw karna hai. Piche tangent is not effective, light is not coming back, okay? Again, new wavefront pe all the points will act as secondary source, emit secondary waves, and therefore the wave will propagate in that way. Similarly, you can also explain it for plane wavefront, and you can also explain it for cylindrical wavefront. Cylindrical or plane mein, I will explain plane wala concept. Construction of plane wavefront, dekho. This is source at infinity. How to make a plane wavefront? I have already told you. What are those two methods? Remember, first one is place the source at infinity. Second is place the source at the focus of a convex lens. So I have taken infinity wala condition. These are the rays coming and this is the wavefront. Here is a red color ka line hai, that is a wavefront. Now according to Huygens' principle, every point on this wavefront will act as secondary source. So I have selected only 5 points. They will act as secondary source, they will emit secondary waves. Let us name those points A, B, C, D, E. They will emit secondary waves, correct? Secondary waves are in all direction. They will emit secondary waves in all direction, but more effective in forward. So tangent in forward will give me the position of new wavefront. So lal wavefront jo tha, wo old wavefront hai. Abhi wo wavefront aage hoke white ho gaya. Means uska new position is white position. Piche dotted hai because less effective in backward. Now white wavefront jo naya wavefront ka position hai, us pe bhi every point will act as secondary source, they will emit secondary waves. Again tangent to it will give me new position. Again every point will act as secondary waves, again tangent to it will new position, and so on, correct? So basically in this way the wavefront propagates. See, I will just show it quick succession mein agar ye play kiya, aise aage jata hai wavefront. Clear? You can see it goes in this direction, in this way. Okay, so this is how plane wavefront propagates. Let us revise all the things that we have covered today, and the revision will be like a small test which you can take. Every question you will get roughly 10 to 15 seconds. Try to solve those MCQs. We will discuss the answers at the end. And if you can score out of 10, at least 8, 9 or 10, then we can consider that you have prepared or you have understood all the concepts very well. If you cannot score above 8, then in that case you can again revisit and again see the video completely so that you will understand the things more clearly, right? So let us start with the test. So there are some questions in front of you. So the first question is, we can see, that is timer side, see, we can see objects due to, what is the reason that we can see the object? Read the question and try to answer the question. You have only 15 seconds. Okay, so time is up. Option is C, we can see objects due to reflection of light from it. We can see any object because when the light bounces off the surface, we can see it. Okay, so answer is C for the first question. Let's have a look at the second question. Tell me what will be the answer for the second question. Your time starts now. Huygens principle is used to, what is the use of Huygens principle? What do you think? Already we have discussed this in theory. Okay, so the time is up. Answer is delta, to obtain the new position of the wavefront geometrically. So that was the third point, the resultant wavefront ka direction, the resultant wavefront ka position we can get by drawing the tangent to the surface. So that is option delta. So question number two, answer is delta. Third question, read the third question. Very simple question. A spherical wavefront propagating in a medium will change into what? Okay, so the answer is beta, plane wavefront. When a spherical wavefront grows in size, finally, eventually it converts into a plane wavefront. That we have also discussed in the part. Fourth question is knowledge-based question. Who gave the first idea of secondary wavelets for the propagation of light? What do you think? What should be the answer for the question number 4? Yes, most of you might have got this right. Answer is Huygens. In Huygens' theory, we have studied this, right? So Huygens gave the idea. Fifth question, read the fifth question and try to solve it. Only 15 seconds. Amongst the following, which shows transverse nature of light? Yes, the answer is beta. Light waves can be polarized. This concept tells us the light is a transverse wave, because polarization out of these four, diffraction, polarization, reflection, interference, in mein se sirf polarization aise property hai jo sirf transverse nature show kar sakta hai, because it is property of transverse wave. Other are properties of all the waves, transverse or longitudinal. Next question is sixth question. Read the question. Very simple question. Cylindrical wavefront can be obtained by. How to obtain cylindrical wavefront? What do you think? What should be the answer? Okay. Yes, the answer is beta. That is by a linear source. Example is tube light. Tube light is a linear source. Usme se hi cylindrical wavefront niklega. Baki point source will give you spherical, and source at infinity will give you a plane wavefront. Seventh question. Have a look at seventh question. Try to solve seventh question. Locus of all points to which wave reaches simultaneously is called. That was definition that we have discussed in the theory. Do you remember? The answer is wavefront. Option is C. Wavefront ka definition hai ye. Okay, now this is theory question. Can you recollect 4 points of Huygens wave theory? Let us start the timer. Just think about it. 4 points. Okay, so time's up. 4 points. Quickly, I will recollect those 4 points. First point was light travels in form of waves, longitudinal waves. Second point was we get sensation of light when the light falls on the retina. Third, different colors are because of different wavelengths. And fourth point was the ether point, luminiferous ether. Okay, can you recollect Huygens' principle ke 3 points? Take your time. You have only 15 seconds, just the points, not the details. Okay, so the time's up. The Huygens principle ke 3 points were, the first point was every point on the wavefront acts as secondary source emitting light in all possible direction. Second point was more effective in forward direction those wavelets are, and third point is tangent gives the direction of the resultant wavefront. Position of the resultant wavefront. And the last question, 10th question is, can you recollect merits and demerits of Huygens' wave theory of light? Merits and demerits. Okay, so let's start. Okay, so time is up. So if you have recollected it, that's good. Merits may reflection, refraction, interference, diffraction, and speed of light in rarer is greater than denser was the merit point. Demerit may kya points the? He could not explain. 5 points were there. Rectilinear propagation, he could not explain photoelectric effect, Compton effect, Raman effect. According to Huygens, longitudinal wave, which was wrong. There was no ether present. He could not explain that as well. So these were 4 standard points in demerits as well. So merits, demerits ke points recollect karna tha. So this is all about the first lecture of today's first lecture of wave theory of light. We will continue with this lecture tomorrow. We will continue it in the second video. First 4 we will revise, these points we will revise, and then we will move to the next part of this lesson, that is reflection and refraction, how Huygens explained those points as well. So it will hardly take 3 or 4 videos to cover this lesson. After this we will also have a test on this lesson, which we will discuss on group, right? So this is all about today's lecture. Thanks for watching the video. Also, you can write in the comment section if you have any doubt regarding this particular video. Thanks a lot.